So if you're doing OnlyFans, you're feeling tired, burnt out, exhausted, and just a general lack of motivation, here's what you can do about it. Let's take a look. What's going on? This is Scotty, and if you don't know who I am, I've been working in social media since 2015, and in this series, we're talking about how I helped my girlfriend reach the top 1% on OnlyFans, starting with zero followers. And don't forget, if you want to see the number one secret, along with a step-by-step guide showing the exact process we use to get these results, just click the link in the description to join me on Telegram. All right, so let's get right into this video. In this one, we are talking about what to do if you are feeling burnt out. So first, let's kind of distinguish, because there's really two phases of burnout. And I feel like, you know, over the years, I've been internet marketing since 2011, but social media automation specifically since about 2015. But over the course of all those years, I've been on both sides of this fence. Multiple times over. There's been times where I've made a lot of money. There's been times where I've been very, very broke. And so I have a fairly good bird's eye point of view when it comes to this, because I've been through this cycle myself many, many times. And so there's really two phases of burnout, right? You have burnout before success, and this is typically due to, you know, a lack of progress. The things that you're doing don't seem to be working, and you really just start asking yourself whether or not it's worth it to continue trying, right? And then you have burnout after success. And this is typically, you know, you've hit your financial goals, you know, things are going well in terms of business, but you may feel a sort of general lack of purpose, and you have no fulfillment in what you're doing and things like that. And so for the purpose of this video, this is the one that we're going to talk about, because this is the type of burnout that probably most creators are facing. So let's get into the details here. Okay, so first, let's talk about sort of the biggest causes for burnout, right? So number one is, you know, you're basically doing the best that you can. You're going above and beyond to make sure that your fans are getting a high quality experience, and then they basically leave your page anyway. So it makes you kind of feel like, why the heck are you putting in all this time and effort? These people don't even stick around. They don't appreciate the things that I'm doing, the content that I'm making, right? Okay, number two is basically getting your TikTok, Instagram, or other social accounts banned and having to start over. So that can be extremely demotivating if you've been working on a certain social media account, TikTok or Instagram, you get 100, 200, you know, 500, a million followers, you've been working on it for a year, and then boom, it gets banned and you're back to square one. And that can be incredibly devastating, demotivating, and make you not want to do it anymore. Okay, and the last one here is basically when you feel like, you know, you're putting in more and more effort and kind of seeing a lack of progress or even a decline in your results. And so again, it kind of makes you feel like, you know, you're putting all this time, all this effort, you're even working harder and harder and harder, and your results seem to be going in reverse, right? And so that can be very, very demotivating and make you feel this sort of burnout and want to give up. Okay, so first understand that all of this is very, very common, is very, very normal in the entire, you know, entrepreneurship world, whether you're doing, you know, OnlyFans or really any other kind of business. Again, I've been through this, you know, cycle many, many times throughout the years. There are, of course, you know, more causes than this, but these are kind of the main ones that I would think most of us face, right? Okay, so now let's kind of go through the problems and the solutions here. So again, number one is kind of doing the best that you can. You're going above and beyond to make sure that your fans are getting experience. They leave anyway, right? So what is the solution? So I've talked about this a handful of times on my YouTube channel, but basically you want to sort of change your frame of reference when it comes to OnlyFans, or basically change your psychology or the way that you think about OnlyFans, and understand that a large percentage of your fans will always leave after the first month, no matter how much effort you put in. And it's not because they don't like you. It's not because your content is not good. Most of the time, these fans, they're only subscribing because they're curious. So they come to satisfy their curiosity and then they leave. And that is okay. That is going to represent the large majority of fans. They come, they satisfy their curiosity, they leave. That's the nature of OnlyFans. So the first thing is to simply accept that that is how it works, despite what other creators might say, or other, you know, gurus or agencies or whatever. They tell you that, you know, you need to focus on keeping people around, getting the best, you know, the most content, all this content, the best content, make sure that people stay. And the simple reality is that that is one of the single best ways to drive yourself absolutely insane, drive yourself to burnout, and make yourself want to give up OnlyFans. Okay, so I always tell creators to sort of treat your OnlyFans page like a physical store. Okay. Your job is to get at least 10 or more new customers in the door every single day so that they have an opportunity to purchase your pay-per-view. If they want to leave after they've made their purchase, then it's okay. All you need to do is focus most of your energy on getting people in the door and not keeping them around. Imagine if you walked into Walmart and, you know, you're shopping around and you purchase things, and then you have all of these people coming up to you and trying to get you to stay in the store for hours on end or days at a time. You're not there to stay. You're there to shop, buy your products, and then leave. And that is what most of these OnlyFans subscribers are trying to do as well. Obviously, that doesn't represent everyone. There are, of course, you know, a certain percentage of fans that will stick around for a long, long time. But they don't need much convincing. If they like you, they like you. They'll stick around. So don't put any effort into trying to convince people to stay. Okay, so just switching into this mindset will relieve a huge portion of your stress and anxiety if you sort of think about it this way. Okay, the next one here is getting your social media accounts banned and having to start over. So the solution here, at least for us, was to use automation and have multiple accounts working for you 24/7. So really, you never want to focus on one or two main accounts. You always want to have many accounts working for you, and you should barely notice when one of your accounts gets banned. You simply do not want to get attached to these accounts. It should not affect you when one of them gets banned. And so what our system kind of looks like is this. So we have, you know, when it comes to Sierra, she has multiple TikTok accounts, multiple Instagram, Twitter, YouTube Shorts, all these different things, Telegram. And so if any one of these accounts were to get banned, which they do, we barely even notice because there are so many pieces to the machine. If a single account gets banned, it doesn't have a huge overall effect on the overall business and the overall marketing system. We simply just replace those accounts and keep doing what we were doing. So this entire machine, the large majority of this is completely automated. And by having a system like this, it will sort of remove your emotional attachment to a certain main account, a certain Instagram account, a certain TikTok account. And so if you want more information about this, I have more information about that. Go ahead and just click the link down in the description and you can check that out. Okay, now with that being said, you always want to have a few category one accounts that have a low probability of getting banned and will slowly grow into large assets over time. So I recently made a video that kind of talks about different categories on TikTok, and you'll definitely want to check out this video so that you can understand what I mean by category one accounts. Okay, and finally here, the last one is putting in more and more effort and sort of seeing a lack of progress or a sort of decline in your results, even though it may seem like you're working more and more over time. And so the solution here is to basically implement scalable systems and growth strategies that have compounding growth over time. Or if you don't want to do that, you can, of course, hire an agency that will do all of that for you. Now, a lot of agencies have, you know, a bad rep in the OnlyFans community because at the end of the day, there are a ton of scammers out there. But there are some legit agencies that have legitimate growth services and can help you do what I'm talking about right here. But just so you know what I mean, let me kind of break this down just to give you a sort of example here. So when I'm talking about compounding growth strategies, what I'm basically referring to is this. Let's take TikTok, for example. Okay, the way that TikTok typically works is you're going to post your videos, and then you're going to get these sort of, you know, viral spikes like this, right? And then you're going to post, you might get, you know, a few spikes, get a big viral spike. But as the platform becomes more and more saturated over time, those viral spikes become smaller, the views, you know, gradually get lower and lower, and it sort of looks like that. Okay, so while TikTok is a great solution to get a ton of fans quickly, you can basically set up an account and get viral videos, and it's really great. It absolutely should be used in your OnlyFans strategy, but you have to understand that TikTok is never going to get easier. It's never going to get more views over time. It's only going to become more saturated over time, and your efforts are going to get less results over time. So you have to understand the difference between, you know, a platform like TikTok or a platform like YouTube, for example, has compounding growth. So the way a YouTube channel works is kind of something like this, where you're posting videos, they get very, very little views, and then over time they start getting more views, and over time they start getting more views, and over time they start getting more views, and it just continues to climb. Why? Because YouTube is essentially a search engine. So just like the video that you're watching right now, there's people that are going to be searching for this today. There's people that'll be searching for this in 6 months. There's people that will be searching for this, you know, in a year from now. So every single YouTube video that I create is going to compound on the last. And that's a big difference between something like TikTok, where it's basically just like playing a slot machine and pulling the lever over and over again, but the payout gets smaller and smaller over time. So at the end of the day, one of the biggest causes for burnout is the lack of progress or the lack of something to look forward to. And so by implementing these strategies, you will have less stress and you will see more progress, which will lead to more motivation and less burnout. But also understand that there is a second phase of burnout once you become sort of financially successful. But we'll go ahead and talk about that in another video. So that's it for this one. Again, if you want to see the number one secret along with a step-by-step guide showing the exact process we use to get these results, just click the link in the description to join me on Telegram. And if you found this video to be helpful, be sure to like and subscribe. And until next time, take care.